You probably don't recognize me. I'm acting. What do you mean?
Yes. Acting. I'm getting all the acting done I can because apparently the actors may be going on strike. And I'm a member of the Screen Actors Guild. I have to go on strike. As an actor, I can still be here as me, but if I act in any way, for example, this... Actually, given the way I perform in this show, I think acting is not something anybody's worried about. There, I don't know about this actor going on strike. I don't know. It's kind of a very contentious issue here in Hollywood. I would just like to say to the actors, though, grow up. You kidding me? There's a recession on. Are you high? You're actors. If you get a job, do it. Oh, I'm going on strike. No. The views expressed by Craig Ferguson are not the views of the mighty CBS Corporation. I believe in the Screen Actors Guild. They've done a great job. They've done righted a lot of wrongs in Hollywood, but I don't think it's time to strike. Do you? I don't. But actors want to strike because it gives them something to do during the day. And you know. Well, you know, the actors on the picket lines, they're going to have to look their best. There'll be the makeup, the high heels, the padded bras. The women will be worse. But if the actors go on strike, the Golden Globes might be cancelled. Yeah, that's what happened last year during the writer's strike. The Golden Globes were cancelled. I think it's time for the Screen Actors Guild to come out on strike. That's what I'm backing them, just for the whole Golden Globes thing, if nothing else. We have terrific guests tonight, and if I can remember who they are, I'll tell you who they are. Yes, I do. Brooke Shields and Dom Herrera are here. Both very good. Both very funny. We'll be back.
Craig Ferguson.
Hi.
Hello.
Come on in. Hi, everybody. Welcome to Los Angeles, California. Welcome to the Late Late Show. I am your host, TV's Craig Ferguson. Please, that's enough. Quietly. Thank you. That's enough. No, honestly, it sounds completely sincere. This guy, I don't know. It's part of the coach trip to see Drew Carey's house. It's a great day for America. It is. It's not such a great day for Michael Jackson. Do you hear about this? He's having a very tough time. He had to auction his famous sequined glove, or as it was known in the courtroom, Exhibit A. Do you know what I'm excited about? That movie that's coming out on Friday, The Day the Earth Stood Still. Keanu Reeves is an enigmatic semi-humanoid alien. I'm not sure what he's doing in the movie, but Keanu Reeves... There, got the joke out of the way, now we can get on the show. Now we can get on the show? I didn't even say on with the show. I don't have time to say with. Do you know who's in the Christmas spirit? Paul McCartney. He has said today that he will allow fans to download his latest project for free. Isn't that fantastic? And Paul's very happy about it. Do we have a picture of Paul? There he is. Hi. There he is. Just when you thought it was over. It's back. It's a great day if you love meaningless awards, because the Golden Globe nominations were announced today. No, I am always cock-a-hoop about the Golden Globes. Not in a good way, of course, because they're crap. The Golden Globe is basically the award that is handed out to whoever kisses the most ass in Hollywood that year. That's right, I said it! It is the least important award. Even the adult video awards are more important than the Golden Globe. By the way, to get an adult video award, you also have to kick a lot of ass. Get a lot of ass. Kick a lot of ass. Losing power to speak. Semi-humanoid alien. Turning into Keanu Reeves. No, you have to kiss a lot of ass to get an adult video award, is what I'm saying. Sometimes the ass kisses back as well. I get nominated for an adult video award, best solo performance. Thank you. Thank you. No, I'm talking about the Golden Globe. The only award less significant than the Golden Globe is, of course, the Nobel Prize in Physics. That's right. I'm talking to you, Yoichiro Nambu. I don't buy your little theory about broken symmetry and subatomic physics, you lying bastard. Like, five physicists going, finally, a joke for us! We've been watching late night for years! There's never been any physics jokes! Well, that was it! There'll never be another one. What am I talking about? Golden Globes, yeah, the Golden Globes, of course, the most corrupt award show in Hollywood. In a town which is no stranger to corruption, here's how it works. The nominations are selected by the Hollywood Foreign Press Association. Now, when you hear foreign press, you think, prestigious journalists, Le Monde maybe, or Der Spiegel, but they're not these guys. They're from the Amsterdam Penny Saver, or the Zurich Yodeler, the Belgrade Auto Trader. These are not... And there's only 90 of these journalists, and every year they vote for whichever studio gives them the coolest gifts. They're for sale. The studios spend millions of dollars trying to bribe the foreign press into giving them a nomination. They should use the money for something productive, like buying a seat in the Senate or something like that. Something useful. The physicists are going, what the hell's he talking about? I don't get that. And the adult video award thing, when he said, kit a lot of ass, what the hell does that even mean? Golden Globes. The Golden Globes, of course, are on NBC. Actually, I've heard that NBC are going to put the Golden Globes on 5 nights a week. The Golden Globes will be on at 9 o'clock, then it'll be Jay Leno at 10 o'clock, then the local news, then Conan, then Jay again, and then more Golden Globes. I was told, they warned me, he said, don't you talk about the Golden Globes. If you trash the Golden Globes, you'll never get nominated for one. I'm thinking, well, the chances are already fairly slim, I would think. You can't get one unless somebody buys it for you. CBS is not going to buy me a Golden Globe Award. They can't buy me a decent suit. That's true. This was left by Bob Barker. By the way, remember to spay and neuter your pets, for heaven's sake. Who wants the Golden Globe anyway? I don't want a little Golden Globe. The only prize I ever want is that little guy named Oscar. There he is over there, actually. You should say hello to him. Say hello, Oscar. There he is. Yeah, very nice. All right. That's a surprise. I wasn't expecting that at all. That's a new outfit. I know. You know, the thing about Oscar is when you pick him up, he's heavier than you would think. I'd like to thank my agent. What am I talking about? The Golden Globes. You know what else annoys me about the Golden Globes? The Golden Globes. Yeah, yes. Not the Golden Globes. They are fantastic. But the Golden Globes, they're corrupt. The Golden Globes. They always nominate movies that are not out yet. Like that movie Benjamin Button got a lot of nominations today. No one's seen it. It stars Brad Pitt. Brad Pitt's in it. He plays someone who's half man, half button. And Keanu Reeves is a semi-humanoid alien. No, in the movie, Brad Pitt ages backwards. When he's born, he's a baby with an old man's face, which is more common than you would think. No, it is. We've got somebody like that at CBS. Do we have a picture of that? Yeah, look, there you go. They'd buy him a Golden Globe. You know who else is in the Benjamin Button movie? Cate Blanchett. Yes, I know she's the greatest actress in the world. I know that. but I'm over it. I know, I've burned a lot of bridges tonight. I know she's a fantastic actress, but I've had enough. You know what it is? It's Cate Blanchett does that annoys me. She always points at her neck in every movie. She's like,
I'm acting. Look at my beautiful swan-like neck. I'm Cate Blanchett, bitch.
Knock it off, put your hand down. Lots of great actors have the signature hand move, though. Cate Blanchett does that. Harrison Ford used to always do this. He would do that. He would do that, and then Robert De Niro used to touch his nose. He'd do that all the time. A little bit. I've got a signature hand move. Actually. Knock it off! Actually, it got me nominated for an adult video award. All right, we have to take a break. We'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back. Do we have time for email tonight, do we? Time to answer an email. Alright, this is from Katie in Harpersville in New York. Harpoorsville, actually. It says Harpoorsville. No, so it's, maybe it's Harpoor. I've never heard of Harpoorsville. I've heard of Harpersville. I haven't. Dear Craig, says Katie, a cop ran over my foot last night. Can you get him back for me by saying something mean about him on your show? Could, but that's the most pathetic act of revenge I've ever heard in my life. Plus, cops don't watch this show. If they did, they'd know I was here. In which case, I wouldn't be here. You get where I'm going with this. No, I can't give the cop a hard time, because if a law enforcement officer ran over your foot, perhaps he had a reason. Perhaps he thought there was a fugitive underneath your foot or something. It's always quite creepy when it does that, isn't it? All right, this is from Tyler in Anchorage. That's in Alaska. Oh, Alaska! Yeah, Alaska's really changed a lot in the last few years, hasn't it? Yeah, Alaska. Remember, it used to be that kind of, oh, I wonder what goes on in Alaska. And then about 6 months ago, we went, ah! You know, we should have her on the show. Should. She would refuse, but we should at least make the offer. She was on the show, you know. You know who I'm talking about, Sarah Palin? Yes, she made me an honorary citizen of Alaska via a videotape. And then she asked to be on the show when she was running as vice president. Well, before that. Before she was running for vice president, she asked to be on the show. And I was like, you're the governor of Alaska. Come on, we've got Andy Dick on. And then she's running for vice president, and I thought, ooh, that would be great. I'll have her on the show. And she wouldn't come on the show then. But she might come back now. Probably not. All right, this is from Tyler in Anchorage in Alaska. Hello, Craig. Why is a pinky called a pinky? This is from Jason in Plymouth in Minnesota. Plymouth in Minnesota? There's a Plymouth in Minnesota? Is that... That... These pilgrims really landed well inland. That Plymouth Rock's a long way from the ocean. Jason says, Craig, can you tell me why they don't have a stupid microphone on the corner of your desk? Oh, yeah. They usually... And a lot of the late-night talk... Well, the proper late-night talk show hosts, they have the... They got your microphone there, you tap it with your pen, you got your that, you got your band going on. You got a proper studio. You have an audience that speaks English. Oh, I'm kidding. They didn't know what I said anyway, it doesn't matter. I don't know. know why I don't have a little microphone? I guess budget reasons is my guess. We have no budget, therefore no microphone. Oh, are we out of time? Do we have to take a break? Oh, we have to take a break. We'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back. Proper one. Look, he's not even plugged in. It's like the phone. Look, they have a phone. Oh, it's one of them new cell phones. It's not even a proper one anyway. This is just like a microphone you see at a karaoke bar. Do you know when the networks bring back the old TV series like Bionic Woman and the Knight Rider? I like that. And they're even bringing back one of my favorite shows, Murder, She Wrote. Take a look at this.
Tonight's episode, Old MacDonald Had a Farm of Death.
Do not touch. Oh, do not touch. No sign on you. Guess I can touch you already.
Hey, stop that, stop that. Oh, I know you. Aren't you Paul McCartney?
No. Well, I get that all the time. I'm actually Jessica Fletcher.
Jessica, oh, right, the famous mystery writer who thinks there's a murder everywhere she goes.
Don't be preposterous. Who am I? Has there been a murder?
No.
I'm still working.
Okay. No, listen, that's King Ramses III.
King Ramses III? Mm-hmm. Excuse me. Mr. Remy, there's a lady here who'd like to sit down.
Come on, please. What are you doing? Stop that. That's a mummy. He's dead.
Dead? Who am I?
No, this man died 4,000 years ago.
Well, you seem to know an awful lot about the victim. Where were you on December the 13th, 2008 BC?
I wasn't born yet.
Oh, a likely story. Oh, it's so dusty in here.
Oh, my God! Oh, that's an ancient Egyptian calendar. It's irreplaceable.
Well, don't worry. I've got another one. I've got a calendar here. Look. My bank gave me this calendar. You can have it. The theme of the calendar is Holland. Every month has a different dyke. You should have a look at February. It's the biggest dyke of all. Hello.
Ma'am, look, I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
Well, I can't leave until I've answered an important question.
Oh, God.
No. Yes. Has there been a murder?
Would you please stop asking that question?
You mean, has there been a murder?
Look, there hasn't been a murder, okay? It says right here that the king died of natural causes, see?
Well, I say he was murdered. Let's look at the clues. This hieroglyphic text here, the fire exit is somewhere around. I'm lactating. It's November. The murderer is King Ramses' brother, Dennis Ramses.
Dennis Ramses? That's ridiculous.
Is it?
Damn. You got me, Fletcher. I murdered my brother, then I drank this elixir that gave me eternal life. I've been hiding here ever since. Stupid. I'll just go have myself arrested.
Wow. Yes. I'm impressed, Fletcher.
Well, I'm impressed by a man in uniform. You know what I like better than a man in uniform?
No, what?
A man out of a uniform.
I'm sorry, but I'm really not interested.
No, I think you are. I think
You're looking like... Oh, I know what you're looking like. You're looking like someone who's in denial.
Oh, wait. I don't get it.
It's a river in Egypt.
Oh.
Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back.
You probably thought it was Kate Blanchett. I'm so terribly clever.
Oh, it's not like she's going to come on this show anyway, is it? Now, my first guest tonight is a very big star, star of the Lipstick Jungle Show, which is on Friday nights on NBC. Brooke Shields, everybody. Time I see
oh,
you.
Oh goodness! Thank
it's
you.
True. You are just you. Look at you. You're adorable oh. And you're tall and you're Brooke Shields, of course.
Thank you. Yeah. And you've grabbed my ass. So
I have grabbed. Yes. I grabbed your ass at the Emmys. Yeah.
Yes.
Only because it was in the script.
Exactly.
Though. Yeah.
I know, and you're a professional.
And it was a script written by you, if you don't mind me saying. So.
All right.
I didn't actually touch your ass during that. I don't know if you noticed. I actually just put my hand in the small of your back.
No. No. It started there, and then it went. It wasn't this.
It wasn't that.
It was
right.
Just. This.
Did it go all the way around to
it
the?
It was a little cupping.
Cupping.
A little bit.
I know.
Thank you.
No, thank you. Thank you for the rest of my life.
And thank you for being so great about the show.
About Lipstick Jungle? Now, yeah, what's going on?
Well, we're, you know, it's like I said when I called you
right.
And was texting you and that we're not, they haven't told us we're canceled. And when everybody thought we were,
right.
They were sending lipsticks and they were blogging and, you know, the sets are still up.
Right.
They haven't told us.
Girls are still getting drunk
in
this.
We're still there,
yes.
And we're still drinking. And
the show's about three women of a certain age, perhaps.
Yeah.
A certain young age.
Okay, good. Thank you. No, it's three women in New York. I mean, and we do so well. We have such a huge audience, but people are not watching it live. They're watching it on DVR and TiVo.
Oh, and welcome to my world.
So, you know, and then we've been moved to Fridays at 9, and then there's going to be 2 weeks where we're off. So I think it's been really hard. But
well, also, it's NBC. It's becoming the Jay Leno network.
I mean, that's
now. You
be...
know, that's it's all Jay Leno all the time.
And
Golden Globes, Jay Leno, Golden Globes, Jay Leno. That's it.
Exactly.
That's it. Oh, didn't you have something to do with the Golden Globes?
No, I was up, at 2:30 in the morning. We had to get up and get all dolled up and go do the announcements. It was fun. I had never done that.
I love the Golden Globes. I don't know if you caught the monologue tonight.
That's why I couldn't wait to talk to you about it because you're such a fan.
I'm crazy for
I
them.
Know.
I can't get me enough Golden Globes. Yeah. Yeah. Well. And what did you do? You made the announcement of who was nominated.
Yeah. We were each given a few categories, and we went, and it was really fun to sort of be there and
that early
stand
in the morning and not be high.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Or not have it be just a from the last night continuing.
Yes, I
so
know.
So it was nice actually. But it was fun. And it gave me an opportunity to come here and see you. So
and I'm very
fun.
Happy that you came because I want to talk to you about because you shoot the Lipstick Jungle in New York.
We're in New York, yeah.
Yes, so I don't see you anymore.
No, and that's I've tried so many times to come back out and
yeah. And
the new show.
And are you enjoying New York City?
I love
are
it.
You from there?
I'm born and raised.
Ah,
born and raised.
I see,
I'm
yeah.
such a New Yorker, and
you enjoy the smell of pee-pee and pizza.
I love yeah. it. And you asked me that the last time, and it hasn't changed. I still love it.
No, it's fantastic. And your kids are there now, right?
They're yeah. there now. Yeah. They're in school there. And, you know, it was a bit of, not even really that much of an adjustment, but it was a bit sort of shocking to just bring everybody to New York. And,
well, what will happen if they do cancel the show? God forbid, will you come back or will you stay in New York?
Yeah, we're kind of, I can't really take her out of school. So right now we're doing that. But she has sort of picked up some good New York language.
Really?
My daughter, yeah, at 5 and a half.
Oh!
Yeah.
What language would that be? Remember, this is CBS.
Okay, but so it's late, so I can sort of say anything.
You see anyway.
So my 5-year-old, she's sitting in the back of the car, and we were just driving out of the city, and she all of a sudden says, oh, I want my window down. Like Botox face. I was like, I don't know what you mean. Do you want your window down, honey? Sure. Like, I was like, I can't make any, can't do it.
No.
So we're having a play date, and this very prominent woman, very wealthy, lovely, comes over to pick up her daughter.
Right.
And they're playing in my kid's room, and Rowan looks at her, and not missing a beat, she goes, what the f- are you doing here?
Okay.
At which point then I'm like in cardiac arrest, and I'm, there's no way to explain it. And she actually turns around and she goes, oh. But I was like, she used it properly. Which just, I was kind
of
proud.
Guy over there. Look at that guy holding his face over there.
You just have
like,
to push
oh
a button,
God.
Right? Don't
yeah,
you just
I know.
Have to push a button that just
no,
shuts
he's
me
not
up
the button
or something?
Guy.
No?
He answers to the button guy.
Oh.
Yeah.
I was sorry. There was like four in there, huh?
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Yeah,
okay.
There was more than that.
And guess what?
It was awesome.
Get out of here, really?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But she didn't actually learn it from me.
Brooke, I've known
you
a long time. She did learn it from you.
No, you find that hard to believe. She actually learned it from my mother. That's why I'm also in therapy.
Ah.
I'm also not meaning you are, but
no, no,
that's why I'm also in therapy.
Yeah, of course. I'm not in therapy at all.
Of course not. You don't believe in that.
As you can tell.
No, you don't need it. Everybody else is crazy.
Oh, my Lord. Are you in therapy, really?
Yeah, I go. I mean, I've gone for years. I love it.
I like it, too. Is it dream therapy you do?
No, it's not dreamy at all. It's just a hard, cold
fact. Is it just the talking with the Austrian guy with smoking a pipe going, tell me about your childhood. Is that kind of
thing? No, it's more eclectic. It's, you know, it's fine. But honestly, I learn more from my daughters just in their way of sort of handling things.
I remember that when my son was born. I think about 2 or 3 minutes after he was born, I forgave my parents for everything.
Really? Yeah.
And he's going to go, oh, God, I get it. Exactly. Yes, of course.
But these kids, they learn so much and they're so clear about it and they teach you so much.
Do you get colds and flus all the time? Because when my son was very young,
all the time.
Yeah, they would bring the...
And they go to school now, so it's...
Right, exactly.
We're just a petri dish. We're just a hotbed of germs.
No, that's
not pretty.
Well, you want to come back to California. It's sunny and things are nice.
Well, I get to see you more.
We could hang out. Yeah.
No, but again, it's really hard. I love L.A. It's been great for me. But to be able to be working in the city in New York, it's so great to go back.
Do you do your Christmas? You can do your Christmas shopping. Have you done that?
I'm already. See, once my show did stop filming,
right.
I became completely my normal type A self and just did everything. They're all out. The gifts are out. I became super mom.
I didn't get mine yet.
It's in the mail.
All right. Okay. Because
it is. You're going to get something.
I'm going to get a present. Really?
Yes.
Really?
It's not human. That kind of a present.
What is it?
They have these bags now. I saw that have an alarm. If you go to the bag before Christmas Eve or Christmas, it sends off this alarm, so you can't even open up the presents if you wanted to.
So I have to wait till Christmas to get my present.
You have to wait till Christmas to get your present. Said the actress to the bishop.
Yeah. All right. Brooke Shields, everybody. We'll be right back. You know, if I had a microphone here, this would be awesome. But I don't. My next guest is one of the funniest comedians in the world. For my money, maybe the funniest. He stars in the Supreme Court of Comedy, which airs Tuesday nights on DirecTV's 101 Network. Wow. Please welcome the very lovely Dom Herrera, everybody. Dom Herrera.
Thank you. Hey, forget about it. Thank you. Beginning of the holiday season, I want to be the first to wish you a Merry Christmas. And for the Jewish people, Merry Christmas. 2009, do you believe it? Everybody says the same thing every year. You believe it's 2009? Yeah, well, since all this year is 2008, I think there's a pattern developing here. They scared the hell out of me. It was 1984, and I had to park cars again for a living. They probably said the same thing throughout time. Do you believe it's the year 4? Wow, 4 years ago, it was nothing. And now it's 4. Go figure that one out. 60 BC, my, how the years subtracting. You know, I never thought that I'd see a day. I mean, how about the history that we're making right now in our country? I've never thought I'd live to see the day that we would have a half a white man as a president. A man. Which gives a lot of mulattoes hope. You know, it really does. You know, any kid who grows up in Hawaii and becomes head of the Harvard Law Board has a chance to be president. That's beautiful. I don't know if you saw in the news today, no NFL players were arrested. It's a big day. I felt bad for Plaxico Burress last week because, you know, he shot himself in the leg, and then they handcuffed him. Did they really have to handcuff him? I mean, what's he going to do, take the gun and shoot his other leg? I'll show you guys. Handcuffs. You know, I got arrested for a DUI, and it was really weird to be in handcuffs because I had never been in handcuffs before without being, you know, completely aroused, if you know what I mean. I didn't know that they didn't come with those little furry things. We had Thanksgiving a little while ago, and you sit around that table, and you thank God that you don't have to live with these people anymore. Thank God. My mother, the most depressing human being in the world. My mother, her favorite game is Guess Who Died. I don't want to play Guess Who Died. All right, guess who has diabetes? How about pink eye? Work with me a little. Every meal was the same. Every meal was about food and disease. Just about the fork to my mouth. You know your cousin Dolores? Yeah, Mom. She's got a big goiter in her neck, bigger than her own head. She has to have it drained. Here, have some gravy. Have a meatball. Come on. Get out and eat. This is my family eating dinner my whole life. Does this taste bad to you? Here, smell that. Here, let me take a big bite in case it's rancid. I wouldn't want you getting sick. Maybe I better test the milk for the cat, too. It's been sitting out for a while. God forbid you go into one of his famous hairball conga agogo fits. I don't know if it's coming out the front, the back. He's going to explode. I want to put the paper. His face, his ass. He's going to blow. Oh, a 4-foot-long matted hair turd. Thank you, kitty. Thank you. So sad. I have a cat that has asthma. You never see anything sad. It's so sad. It's like the little thing, little help. It's like, meow, woo, woo. Take him to the vet. He gets his asthma shot. I'm just about to leave. The nurse turns to the doctor. She says, you know, sometimes his anal glands get impacted. How she knows this, I have no idea. The doctor puts a white latex glove on and starts going like this. The cat, like he knows, like he senses something new and wonderful about to happen. His ears snap back like he's being shot through a wind tunnel. They bring in a sumo wrestler to hold the cat's back legs down. The doctor takes a running start, pops my kitty. The cat goes, meow, meow. Now I got the doctor call me up drunk 4 o'clock in the morning. Can you bring the cat down? Maybe I better check him one more time. Just put him on the phone. Let him decide. He's an adult, man. What is he, 4? Thank you, everybody.
Come on over. Damn fine to see you, young fella. How are you?
I'm good.
How you in good form.
How you doing there, Pops?
Yeah, I'm all right. Did you really get a DUI this year?
Yeah, that's true,
isn't it?
That was horrible. And a guy pulls me over, and the thing that bothered me, well, first of all, I wasn't drunk, which I hated to waste it, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, I wanted
because
to be,
you're drunk often.
Well, I drunk all the time. Right now, I'm blitzed. No, but I mean, I wanted to have, like, be seeing triple out of one eye. I said to the guy, don't I seem lucid to you? He says, you're sober. I go, why are you arresting me? It's because of what you blew. I blew like a 1 point something, 1.1 or something. And he already said to me, he goes, I'm a very big fan of yours. I go, apparently not big enough.
Yeah, really?
You know what a big fan does? Takes me to Dunkin' Donuts, let me play with the siren, takes me home. That puts me in jail.
Did they put you in jail? Did you have to send jail overnight?
Oh, it was horrible, man. And I'm such a wuss. I start ratting out all my friends. Listen, man, if you let me out a half hour early, I tell you what, my friend Julio keeps his pot. Come on, let me out of here.
Did you get claustrophobic? Were you nervous in the show?
Well, I had like a high blood pressure. Yeah, I'm an actor. I'm not really a tough Italian guy.
Yeah, right.
I'm a wuss, you know. I got.
Like, did you have to go to a judge the next day and everything?
No. The judge was about like a month or so later, and she was up there, and she had like this bad wig on, and you know how like in life there's an inner dialogue, you know, and she's saying, and I'm going, yes, Your Honor, and I'm thinking, yes, you son of a bitch, I hope you have a kid who. Well, every time he talks, he spits food in your soup. But In lieu of that, I said, yes, Your Honor.
Yeah, you didn't actually say that out loud. It was inner dialogue.
It was really horrible. I mean, I'm in there with these gang members. The one kid wakes up and he goes, hey, Dom, what are you doing here? I'm doing research on drunk and driving. That's what I'm doing here. And he said to me, he got kind of wistful. One guy, I was staring at the clock, he goes, brother, you got to stop looking at the clock, man. It'll kill you. You know, he goes, when I first started getting arrested, like you could almost hear like soft music in the background. I used to look at the clock, but now, you know, I play pinochle, I laugh, you have to adapt. And I'm thinking, this is the smartest guy here. You know? I had the one lady says, where are you from originally? I said, Philadelphia. She goes, what city in Philadelphia? I go, Philadelphia is a city. And I'm thinking, you idiot, you know?
Yeah, don't say it.
No, I couldn't.
No, you don't want to start that you could get shanked.
Oh, it was horrible. Yeah. And I had to go to AA, right? You have to go to 6 AA meetings. And their stories were so horrible that I had to make up stuff to make. Okay. Oh, yeah, I was raped by wolves as a 4-year-old. But I mean, it was like, I go in, it's supposed to be Alcoholics Anonymous, and I go in Philadelphia, and the guy goes, hey, is that Dom Marrero? I go, hey, Dom Marrero, right? He goes, you look like Dom Marrero? I go, I am. He goes, wow. I go, I thought it was Anonymous. He goes, man, I can't wait to tell my wife I saw you in here.
Yeah. Well, nothing's perfect, you know, I mean, that's the way. Are you what are you doing for the holidays? You going back to Philly?
No, I can't go back there.
Why not?
I just was there for Thanksgiving. I can't. I don't want to get those people presents. And like I'm trying not to go out with anybody like this couple weeks.
Are you single?
Well, I am now. Yeah.
Look out, ladies. Really?
Well, yeah, who wants a little fat guy with a DUI?
No, come on.
You have to drive him around all the time. Yeah, I've been. But yeah, I want to ask you seriously. I'm getting women calling me about you.
About me?
But I swear to God, this woman Kathleen, a friend of my ex-wife's in Georgia. She wants to go out with you, right? And I don't know what to say. I mean,
Tell her no.
Yeah. I mean, like I feel like I'm your pimp. Like I got people calling me up.
You're not my pimp. My pimp's a guy called Raul. You're not my pimp.
Oh, Raul.
Yeah. You know Raul with the big purple soft velvet hat. You know what I'm talking about.
He's your pimp too?
Yes, he's mine too.
He's good.
He's very good. Listen, it's always good to see you. Come back and see us anytime soon.
But what do I say to women that ask me about you? Just
tell them I'm a European. You know.
Oh. Metro. All right, you got it. Yeah, thanks, brother.
Come around, everybody. Come around, bud.
Sir?
I'm Brian Fenchel.
Yeah, I haven't seen an afro like that in a while. It looks good on you. I'm not saying nothing. I'm not casting aspersion on you, but I just want to say that the whole night I'm going to be thinking, what is he thinking, but I'm not going to mention it. Has anybody taken you aside and told you maybe you should have an alternative hairdo?
Yeah, my grandmother tells me that all the time.
So you hang in a pretty rough crowd.
What did we learn on the show tonight, Greg?
Very, very Christmassy. You know what I learned on the show, Brooke, tonight, was that if you talk too much about Lipstick Jungle, you don't get time to talk about your new book or your charity or
all this stuff. Collins, Welcome to Your World baby book.
Yes.
I wrote this book about my daughters and about a sister waiting for the birth of her baby sister.
And there's a picture of you.
And there's me, and those are my little girls. It kind of inspired me to do more charitable work, just about wanting to inspire my little girls to be confident. And there's this charity called Chain of Confidence. And it's actually Tupperware's Chain of Confidence. And
Tupperware?
Yeah.
Do they still have Tupperware?
Over $1 million they're giving to the Boys and Girls Club.
I tell you, that
and
keeps your crap
it.
Fresh forever.
I know. It was one of the first places where women were able to stay at home and also earn a living. So these
Tupperware parties, of course.
Exactly. And so it was like ahead of its time.
Yeah.
And now they've put over $1 million a year into the Boys and Girls Club to a program that called Smart Girls and to inspire young women and to help them and educate them. And there's a Camp Confidence online where they can learn
how
to balance their
checkbook. Where's the online address?
Checkbook.
We have the online address there. Yeah, you are.
Chainofconfidence.com. And it's a great place for people to go and that don't have the resources to learn about finances, about health, about sex. Like these kids, you know, it's a place that they can go. Why do you always you go there? It's
I like, know, you
oh,
go
I
there.
Go
you
there.
Go
you inspire
there.
Me to go there.
Get out of here. We'll see you tomorrow.
All right, yeah.